Hello everyone. Today let us see how to monitor the ports via Zabbix. Port monitoring is important in those places where we are having some applications or websites running on a non-standard port, or even on a standard port. It would be very necessary for us to know a particular port running or not. It could be blocked because of the firewall conditions, or the application might have gone down. So whatever reason it is, so we have to monitor the particular ports on a particular machine. So every port is associated with a server. Say for example, on the Zabbix server, the port 80 and 22 are running, but say port 443 is not running, or it's not configured to run. So if I configure the monitoring for all these three ports, we can see how the port 80 and 22 works perfectly, whereas it throws an alert that port 443 is not running. So let's go about it. So we'll have to go to configuration, click on hosts, and then search a particular host, say for example Zabbix server, and click on the Zabbix server. I'm going to the applications. So before going to the items, I have to create an application, and let me create an application, the name of port. Okay, and click on add, so that it helps me in segregating the alerts in the latest data. So it's very easy for me to put all the port related monitoring if I have an application in that name. So clicking on the items, I am selecting create item, and now I say 80 underscore port. Okay, and then the key is net.tcp.service open square bracket http or https comma comma port number 22 close the bracket. So this is the simple key that we have to use. Let us give the updating frequency as 10 seconds, and then don't forget to select the applications as port. Click on add. Okay, so if we just click on port, oops, did I make a mistake? Yeah, right, I made a mistake. So I instead of port 80, I'll give it as port 22. Okay, yep, click on update. So this is updated as port 22, and we are monitoring port 22. Let me create another item. Let us now create as 80 underscore port, and then the key as net.tcp.service of http comma comma 80, and then select the application as port, and then click on add. And now let us create another item in the same breath. Let's say 443 underscore port, and the service, I mean the key is net.tcp service of https 443, and the update interval is 10 seconds. Let me click the application as port, click on add. Okay, now I selected a filter for port. Let's see. Okay, for port 80, I have kept just retain the update interval as 1 minute. So let me just make it as 10 seconds. Click on update. Okay, now all the port monitoring is done. I'm gonna click on the name, then click on update. So let's go to the latest data, and then I filtered for the Zabbix. Let me put the application as port, and then click on apply. See, the port 443 is not running, the last value is 0, whereas for port 22 it is running. For 80 it is yet to fetch the data. Okay, so this is how basically we can monitor the ports on Zabbix. So it's as simple as that, right? Yeah, great. We have got the value for port 80 as well. So we can see the port 80 and port 22 are running, whereas port 443 is not running. So obviously it is showing as 0, which means it is not running. So accordingly, what we can do is we can go to triggers, and then we can configure trigger for these monitoring saying that particular port is not running. As you click on trigger, I say port 443 or port 80, whatever it is. Click on informational and then expression, select add item, and then port 443. I'll just select that. Okay, if it is equal to 0, then throw the alert. Let me keep it as warning. Okay, click on add, and then update. So let me just duplicate this, and then we go to problems. Right, see, you can see port 443 is not running. Isn't this beautiful? More in the next.